Yeah, we're on. Right, okay. So, try not to get me facing. Right, welcome everyone who is watching. Welcome to Davian Primary School, where we have Mr. and Mrs. Hesketh, my nan and granddad. You can wave at them if you want. There we go. And then we've also got our year six children. Right, okay. So, what we are going to do this afternoon is we're going to talk to my nan and granddad, Mr. and Mrs. Hesketh, about their time being evacuated. So just before we talk about the actual evacuation, do you just want to introduce yourself, sort of whereabouts you grew up in Manchester, and what was your family like? So who, how many brothers, sisters, that sort of thing?
Well, I was one of 11. I had 7 brothers.
You had 7 brothers, and you were the only...
No, there was 3 girls.
3 girls, 3 girls, 7 brothers. Right, and whereabouts did you live?
I lived off Greenays Lane, on Moss Side.
In Moss Side. What about you, Grandad?
I lived in Oomer. I had 1 brother and 1 sister.
And 1 brother and 1 sister. And what was the first sort of time you realised, what was it that made you realise that we were at war? Or did you even know we were at war?
Oh yeah, I knew. 1939, when war was declared, I could read the newspapers.
And how old were you?
Between 7 and 8.
Between 7 and 8.
Somewhere between 7 and 8. Can't be precise.
Right, brilliant. And how long was it from you finding out that we were at war? Was it until you were evacuated?
Oh, within weeks. Within weeks.
So it was quite soon.
It wasn't compulsory. You weren't forced to go.
It was for safety for the children. Yeah. You know?
If your parents thought it was the best thing for you to go.
To go, were you?
It's for safety reasons. Because that's the reason you were sent away. Was to keep you away from the bombing areas.
And the guns.
You know, so... you know, you didn't have to go away. You didn't have to be evacuated.
And it was mainly the main sort of town, cities that were the children were evacuated from, because that was where most of the bombing happened. Yeah. Can anyone think of why, when the Germans were bombing, they were bombing the major cities? Joe?
Because that's where they have like the factories and everything.
Yeah, so if they could destroy all the sort of factories, we wouldn't be able to... sort of create the weapons
and,
the docks and that sort of thing.
Docks where all the food and arms came in.
Before you were evacuated, were you ever? Did you ever go into an air raid shelter?
Yes.
That's right.
And what was that? What was that like? So what? Tell me through what would happen there. What would
It was a concrete air raid shelter, and it was at the end of the houses, and it was quite big, and you just had plain benches, and so as soon as the sirens went, because there was sirens at the beginning of any aircraft had been seen or detected, they put the sirens on, and that was the time for packing and going into the air raid shelter.
And when did that normally happen? What time of day?
Anytime.
Anytime.
Afternoon, anytime,
during
the day and night.
And how many people used to go into the air raid shelters? How many would go into it?
Oh, there's quite a lot.
Hundreds. Some of them were very big. Some of them, the one I went to was underneath the cinema, and they could get 200 people in there.
Right. And what was it like when you were in there? Did you...
Claustrophobic.
We were frightened because of the guns, because you could hear the guns going off. And my mother used to always take a roll of cotton wool. So she'd bang the cotton wool in your ears. And then, as I say, you'd always have someone who could sing or dance and try and keep the children happy, you know, because it was so frightening.
And how long would you be in the air raid shelter for?
As long as we
got the all clear. The sirens would go again and that video clear.
And would that be a couple of hours, whole night?
It could be all night.
Well, depending how long the raid lasted. they soon knew when the planes were going back to Germany. Soon, and then they gave the all clear.
Right, okay. And so when was the first time you found out that you were being evacuated? And who told you?
The school tells you, and the Ashy parents were they agreeable for you to go. And my mum and father thought it was the best, safest thing.
Same with mine.
So. My sister didn't go, but me and my brother went.
And was it just children who were evacuated? Or
Yes.
Did your teachers go with you?
The younger ones went with, like, babies and that, would be evacuated with the mother.
Right.
And they went to Blackpool and places like that for evacuation,
And whereabouts did you go to? Where were you evacuated to? So you went from Manchester to...
Bakewell, mate, Derbyshire.
Bakewell.
And I was Nelson in Lancashire, near Burnley.
Right, okay. So what was it like the morning you were... Was it a morning or was it evening?
Morning.
What was it like being... So first thing, what were you allowed to take with you?
Well, you could take a change of clothes,
a gas mask.
And your gas mask, and then you had your lapel label to tell what your name was, where you was from, what school you was at, and then it was just you was all gathered into a hall and lined up, and then you got the coach to the station, and after you went to, and then when you got there, you was put back into the hall again, school hall, and they brought these people in who was taking you to their home for safety. So they picked who they wanted.
And you didn't go alone, did you? You went with
No, I went with three brothers. I was the girl with the three brothers. And the eldest one was the one who was told to make sure we never got split up because he was coming back within a couple of months because he was leaving school at 14 and he'd got a job. So it meant that the three of us would be on our own then.
So your mum wanted you to stay together?
Oh, she made definitely strict orders and not to be split up.
And you stayed together, did you? So the family took all of you?
Yes.
But they didn't really want you, did they?
No, not me anyway. The youngest one, Tony, he was the favourite. But she already had a daughter and I think there was quite a lot of jealousy, to be honest.
Right. Because the families in the evacuated areas where you could take you, they were sort of almost forced into taking people, weren't they?
No, they volunteered.
Oh, they volunteered.
Yeah, they volunteered. They didn't have to have us.
And they did get paid for it.
Oh, did they?
They got paid.
Oh, yeah, they got good money for it. And they got all the ration vouchers for the rationing.
Yeah. And how long were you on the train for?
Not long. Because it's not far.
I was only on the bus for about an hour or so to Nelson.
And how did you feel? How did you feel when you left the family?
I didn't. To me, it was a big adventure at that time, that age.
Yeah, exciting, something new.
It was for boys.
Yeah. I can imagine I cried and cried.
Oh, well, I couldn't.
It was a big adventure.
The lads, my brothers was fine.
Yeah,
and did you go with your brother?
Yeah.
Were you together as well?
Yeah, we was in the church hall and everybody had gone. It was only me and my brother left. So a chap came in and he said, come with me. And we went walking down streets in Nelson and come to this house. He opened the door and they said, we asked for two girls. I said, well, there's no girls left. She said, can I either have these or? She said, oh, we'll have them. So we went in. My brother lasted 2 weeks.
It
was a naughty boy, actually.
Was it? And what? And did you go to school?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. My school was called St. George's.
Right. And what was that like? Was that different to school at home, or was it similar?
Very good.
You liked it. What about you?
I did.
You didn't like it. Why?
they kept us at the back, as you know, at the back of the classes, as though it was the shouldn't be there. And you really did feel it.
Oh yeah, you know. The local children resented you.
Yeah, they did.
And you in the way,
Mike,
shouldn't be there.
Yeah, you shouldn't be there.
Yeah, you seem to think you were taking their place. Mm. And they did resent you. You used to have funny names, but we were evacuees, really, but they just called them backies.
Yeah,
that was like an insult.
That's what you were known as.
Yeah. They were very cruel, but it was kiddish, you say it.
Better. What was life like then when in the home that you stayed in? So with the family that you stayed in, what was it like?
Mine was, she was quite cruel.
Well, the mother?
The mother and the father. He was a coal merchant, so he delivered coal. And he always wore a big leather belt. So if we was not doing as we was told, she'd tell him and he'd bring the belt to him.
And give you a...
On the leg,
A couple I went to live with, they treated me like their own son.
Yeah.
And yeah, they did.
They never had children.
No, and I was there for over 2 years. And when I came back home, I used to go and visit them, they come and visit me.
Yeah.
And then my name wasn't Esketh then.
Mm-hmm.
But I was, so grateful for what they'd done for me.
Mm-hmm.
I changed my name to Esketh, which was their name.
Oh, wow, really?
Yeah,
you felt part of their family.
Yeah.
So you were saved for and part of their family.
Yeah.
No, can't tell the different experience.
You come wait. How long were you there for then? How long did you stay there for? So you were there for 2 years. What about you, Nama? How long were you?
I'd say about a year.
And did your parents ever come and visit?
Oh, yeah.
My mum would come every other Sunday on the bus.
Right. I mean, with me being off a big family, my mother couldn't do it every fortnight or whatever, she'd always try and get up as often as she could. So with that, you just got used to it.
And tell us a story about the dress. Was it the dress for your birthday?
Oh no, it was Easter. It was Easter, and they were Church of England. Where I was brought up as a Catholic, and so my mother had sent. Well, she'd come that weekend and she brought me a straw bonnet with a dress and a lovely coat, socks, underwear, all new stuff. And she didn't have a lot of money. So to me, it was wonderful, So when she went back home, I expected that to be put on me on Easter Sunday. And she put the lot on her daughter and took me to her church, Methodist church.
Right, so she sort of stole the dress off you and put it on her own daughter.
And they'd lock us out in the cold, and the winter was shocking there because it snowed. It was our farm and animals, And she used to lock us out in the snow and the rain. And the woman next door took us in one day because we was absolutely crying, the three of us, with the cold. And she gave us the hot drink, and she was a very poor woman because she had a big family who lived next door to them. And it was her who wrote to my mother and told my mother to come and pick us up because this woman was.
And did anything happen after it? Did they?
Not as I know of.
Nothing.
I was only I'd be going on for 9 then.
Right. And how old were your brothers?
Joe was 3 years older than me. So he knew it. Tony was 14 months younger than me.
So he was
just a little chap kind of thing. And he took everything. But he was okay. She loved him.
Yeah. I do like you.
How old was their daughter? How old was their daughter? It was similar
she,
age.
She was a similar age to me, you know.
And how did they treat her?
Oh, fine.
Fine.
Yeah. They gave her all my chocolate at my back, isn't it? You know, the parcel, they gave you a parcel when you was living there and it had chocolate and sweets in. Things we've never had once the war started because it was so short and there was no fruit. And so we had each evacuee got this food parcel and she took the lot. And that we never got any chocolate. Okay. And that's when I got a good darling because I kept saying, where's the chocolate?
Yes. Who else would be asking where their chocolate was? Yeah.
So what sort of things did you do? Didn't the father of the family you stayed with, didn't he sort of take you out all the time and you'd go on?
Yeah.
He taught you to do certain things.
Oh, I used to, when I went to school, after school, I used to go to a reservoir where this chap was a member. And we used to go fishing on the reservoir for trout. And then, yeah, we used to have it every Sunday morning for breakfast.
And what catch the fish and then?
Trout, yeah. Yeah. It was lovely. They really treated me like their own. And, it was unbelievable, really. I didn't expect it.
And so what happened with your brother then? When he went to stay with another
family? It lasted 2 weeks. Then they sent him to a boy's home. But he didn't last long there. He escaped.
Yeah, he was right there.
And he actually, this is true, he walked 30 miles from Nelson to Manchester.
To Manchester.
He walked
the
it
railway.
Up.
Railway. Did he?
And he was only...
The lines on the
railway. He'd be about 10.
Wow.
My eldest brother done,
so. Yeah. Just to get back
home. Yeah, and the police rang my mother and father and said, we've got your son here. And he was in, you know, Prestwick care, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And the mum and the father.
And that was it. He could have done no more.
Never went.
And what was Christmas like? Do you remember what it was like at Christmas? Is it celebrated much? Did you get to go home or did your family
No.
Very
subdued
Christmas.
It was.
I bet you didn't get the same sort of presents these lot get.
Oh, no.
What would you get for Christmas present when you were about the, so what are we here, 9, 10, 10, 11?
Yeah.
When you were about 9, 10 when you were evacuated, what would you wake up on Christmas morning
it'd be,
and get?
It'd be like a little doll, plastic. Little doll and maybe sweets. We used to have the pennies, you know, the chocolate pennies, and games. We had puzzles and books, little books, drawing books, and things like that. You know, we didn't have anything.
Not like these lot.
Oh,
spoiled.
No. Well, the first Christmas present I can really remember.
Not spoiled.
Was both my brother and I got boxing gloves. We made use of them.
Yes.
And
as brothers do.
Did you have any family who were involved in the war? Did you have any family who?
My mother had three brothers, so all abroad, Dunkirk and places like that.
What about you, Nana?
Same. They are. You know, two was my eldest brother was in Egypt, you know.
When you grew up, didn't you join the army? Weren't you in the army? Yeah,
national service.
Yeah, and talk us through that. Talk us through what, because we don't have to do that nowadays, do we?
No.
You have to. So talk us through what that. So how old were you when you
reached the age of 18? You had to go. That was compulsory.
You had to join the army.
You had to go.
For how long?
2 years.
Two.
You could stay if you wanted, but you was compulsory to do 2 years.
Right.
And actually, I loved it. And I went to Germany. I spent most of my time in Germany in a tank regiment, and I was a wireless operator, so I was the only one in the camp who could do it.
And did you feel like you benefited a lot from that experience?
Oh,
so
yeah.
You learned a lot?
Yeah, I did.
And that sort of thing, brilliant. Right, I think we can ask some questions, get the children to ask some questions now. So hopefully you've been listening carefully to that. And if there's any other questions that we've not covered there, you can ask them. But just make sure you say your questions nice and loudly so we can pick it up on the microphone here, and also my Nana and Grandad can hear it. So have you got your...
Yeah,
ready? Got your hearing aid turned up. Right, Miss Burns, I'll let you choose.
Okay, a conjure. Do you have anything like physical memory from the war?
Oh, yes. We used to be thrown out of the house to go and do what we wanted, and it was surrounded by fields and cattle, and then there was a big forest there, and we used to go in the forest. Again, you know, all the little boys, all the school friends. And one of them had probably had matches, so he'd light the fire first. So we'd all be around the fire, say, in the forest. And then all of a sudden, we was all sat there, and all of a sudden, we had just such a big explosion and crash. So we all get up and we run, and a plane had come down in one of the fields where the cattle was, and it was a German plane. So we all run, but the police was there and they coded the plane off. But the boys was trying to get pieces of the plane to take home, you see, when they was going, you know, when they was going to go home. Anyway, one or two of them did, but that was one of the worst things we ever saw, to be honest.
And do you have like a sort of, it's not from the war, but you've got an ornament of an evacuee, haven't you, in your house?
Yes, I have.
Just
yes.
As
a boy with it, all his gas mask on and things like that, you know.
Right, Brill.
Thank you. Lily.
When you went home, did you ever see your evacuee family?
No.
I did. I used to go, they used to come and see me, and I used to go and see them. In fact, the last time I went, it was about 6 years ago. I saw the lady who was, I stayed with, she died. And then I heard she was dying, so I got down there as soon as I could, just before she died.
So did you meet them as well? Did you meet
the
Hesketh as well? Yeah. And did they come to everything, like the wedding? And
No, they didn't, actually. They didn't come to the wedding, did they? They didn't come to our wedding.
No, we weren't.
I don't think you've been in touch with them.
No, I came out of the army, when I came out of the army.
Because we was both 21. And Derek hadn't been out of the army when we met long. So, and then it was the following year we got married. It was only...
54.
So how many years is that now?
Oh,
62,
I think.
62. Look at that. That deserves a clap, I think. Right, another question.
Giovanni, if the war team to life completely,
I never thought about it after. I think now, because of all you young ones growing up, I hope to God you never go through the same thing again. Because it was so frightening. And I just put it at the back of my mind, and I went back to my old school anyway, and forgot. They want to, and my mother never allowed the ones we was evacuated with to come over to see us or anything, which I wouldn't give them to see them.
Thank you. Taib,
what time did you have to go to sleep at night?
Oh, as soon as we'd had our tea, she'd had us up and
said, did you?
Yeah, I'd say about 7 o'clock.
They let me play outside.
Is that?
There's a park near me. I could play out till about 7 o'clock and then come back home, have some supper, and off to bed.
And what would you eat? What would back then? What would you say? What was supper? What would you have for supper back then?
Well, there was very good bakers in Nelson. They still are, I think. But it was a cake. It's called Parkin.
Right.
And that's not what I used to have
for your supper.
Once we had our tea, we didn't have a supper.
And what about, what did you have for tea? What would it be usually? Because it was rations back then, wasn't it?
Yeah,
so rations. What sort of things would you be able to have, and what weren't you able to have?
We had quite a bit of meat because, as I say, it was farming. Yeah. So she wasn't sure cooking, you know, a meal like with meat and veg. And as I said, it was all
fruit was the big
problem. But fruit was, and sweets and things yeah. like that, you never got.
You didn't get much fruit because of, especially bananas, which are imported.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So, you know, fruit was just
and the apples were scarce.
Like a Christmas, a treat would be like a satsuma, is that like, or a tangerine? Have I made that up?
Christmas, no, Christmas, well, we used to get a stocking, didn't we? With a chocolate penny in and a tangerine. And maybe if you
were lucky, apple. I'm sure there's a lovely stocking like that for Christmas.
Definitely. Lola?
Did anyone very close to you die? Or like a relative?
No. You mean during the war?
Yeah.
No. Thank God.
Joe? Did you live in the city? And if so, how did it feel moving to the countryside?
Well, we did live in the city, didn't we? We both lived in the city, But you was in the countryside more so than me.
Yeah,
you know, to be honest.
Nelson was out every day.
We used to go to the animal markets and see the pigs and things like that on a set because you'd throw us out and stuff.
Yeah, you have to go.
And whether it was snow, rain, hail, whatever, you had to go. And we'd go there to the
animal market,
see the animals.
Nice.
You
know,
Tyler,
do you know when you had to go to
the airway shelter, what were you feeling? Oh, frightening. Very frightening, because you could hear the guns trying to hit the airplanes, and the noises were very frightening.
Because it fly really low, was it? Wasn't you? It's grandma, wasn't it? When she said that her house got bombed,
yeah,
and she could actually see the planes were so low, she could see the pilot.
Yeah, that's right. On Victoria Avenue, that.
That's right.
So
it was
kind of
scary.
Sam,
did you have any friends when you were evacuated?
No, not really. Only school. We used to, you know, some of the only the vacuums, not the people who live there. But the vacuums, they all seem to try and stay together. You know, if one got hurt, they all would come round and make sure he was okay. You know, but it was just at one table. You didn't mix with the others because they needed to
separate. Yeah,
yeah.
They,
the local children resented us.
Resented,
They didn't realise what was going on, but
no,
they did resent. I mean, one of the relatives of the family, he certainly didn't like me.
Yeah.
But I had nothing to
do. It was probably jealousy, wasn't it?
It was.
Because I was being well looked after.
Yeah. Who's this? They weren't here before. Taking my place.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's right.
Erin.
Did you ever have to use a gas mask?
Yeah.
What was that like then?
We had to keep having trials, didn't we?
Practice with them.
We had to keep practicing to make sure.
Babies had like a
cot.
A cot.
Yeah.
And it was, you could put the baby inside and zip it up so the baby was safe.
But we had practices.
The bit of Mickey Mouse one too.
Yeah, they had Mickey Mouse one.
Mickey Mouse.
Gas mask. Did they have it?
No.
Not really. Have it? No. Clumsy.
Yeah.
Clumsy.
A bit awkward to put on.
Yeah. You were like an elephant.
Yeah. Archie. Did any of the other evacuees not know like what pigs were or cows were?
Oh yeah, they all knew. Yeah. Because we all used to go to the market.
No, but before, do you know, before, I think what it means is before you actually were evacuated.
Oh, no, I've never been. No.
So it was like completely new, so they'd never seen those sort of animals.
Yeah, we didn't see anything like that.
So I guess you got different experiences out of something terrible.
That's right.
You have different experiences. Abby,
were you excited about leaving home?
No, I wasn't.
Were you excited about leaving?
Well,
it was a big adventure, like, you know.
It wasn't for me. You weren't
upset, you weren't crying or anything like that, because you were leaving home. It was just...
Who would be excited? Put your hand if you feel excited. Put your hand if you feel scared and worried. Yeah, it used to be a girl-boy thing, I think.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
I'd have been scared.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would have been... I've seen it as a big adventure.
Billy,
when you first heard what you were going to be evacuated, what were you thinking?
I didn't take it in at first, and then a couple of days after, the teacher started to tell us what was going to happen, and then I realised, and then my mum and my dad had a word with me, and because I was the only girl with my brothers. And I said, you know, I was crying, I don't want to go, I don't. But she said, like, it was for the safety of us all. So when I did go, I couldn't leave. I had all of a skirt.
Not wanted to go. Hayden.
Were you excited about leaving your parents?
Oh, very unhappy. Was you happy about leaving your parents? Or
Amber? Not really, you. I never thought about that, you know. So when I was away, I missed, when I was living in Nelson, I didn't miss it. And my mother used to come and see me. You know, she used to get the bus. And,
yeah.
She used to come and see me every other Sunday.
He still saw them at some time.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because I think for some, if they got evacuated too far away, I probably think London wise, if you were evacuated in London.
Oh, well,
went
to Canada, didn't they?
Oh, yeah. Some went abroad.
Yeah. Some went to Australia.
So in a way, you were lucky that you were away from it, but you weren't too far.
Too far from home.
Yeah. Walking distance.
That's right.
Yeah. Your brother.
That's right.
Sophie.
If you had any siblings that didn't go with you, what did they do?
So with your brothers and sisters that stayed at home, what did they do during that time?
Well, the ones that did stay at home was the working. They had jobs, you know.
What sort of jobs did they have?
Vic, who was over us like when we was evacuated, he had to leave after a certain amount of weeks because he had a job at the Chronicle.
Right.
He was a reader on the Evening Chronicle, so he had to, and the others was on the railway, one was on the railway, and my dad was on the railway.
And did your mum work?
My mum worked at the government offices, yeah.
And what about you, what did your mum and dad do?
A lot of the girls, though, they went on what you call a women's land army, and they're working on farms.
On farms, yeah.
And they really loved it. They got
paid. They got well paid.
Yeah.
You got the best food.
Yeah,
right?
Physically demanding. Yeah.
But
I had friends who
landed.
Yeah.
And what did your mum and dad work? What job did they have?
My mother was a cleaner for the government offices, and my father was a checker at on the railway.
What about you, Grandad?
Oh, my dad worked in a flour mill. And my mother, she didn't really work as such, you know.
Well, she had the baby, didn't she? Had them too.
Yeah, she had my sister. She was a baby, so she didn't work.
So it's a lot of the jobs very hands on. Really back then.
Oh, yes.
Physical
work. Jobs probably would pay off now.
Yeah, no. Probably a lot of jobs that sort of machines do now, sort of technology's taken over a lot of the sound. Right, should we have a couple more questions? How are we doing for time? Yeah, a couple more questions.
Paige.
Now that you knew what your parents would have been like, if you had the choice to stay, would you have stayed in London?
Yeah, so given the choice between knowing what you went through when you were evacuated, good question this, and the families that you stayed with, would you have still gone? Would you have still...
You would have gone.
Yeah. Because what's amazing about this is, I think
it's like a tale of two halves, isn't it?
Yeah, I think a lot of children had the similar sort of.
Yeah, I didn't.
I didn't imagine that you would come and share good experiences. I'm not saying, you know, it was amazing, but it's nice to hear that you enjoyed your time there, which I didn't expect to hear you say, really.
None of them, all the ones what was evacuated, wouldn't know what the people was going to be like.
It's kind of luck of the draw, wasn't it?
And that really, to be honest with you, when you come to think about it, it was bad.
Yeah.
Because you didn't know who you was going to go to.
You could be going and to anyone.
And they'd come and they'd say, I'll have her.
Yeah,
all this business, you know.
And how that made you feel, like they don't want me.
That's
right. Yeah. And when in that room when that happened, so you were taken, you got off the train, you were taken into that. Yeah.
Strict,
at least it's got my little sister, but obviously at that point, sort of worse. Yeah. Right, we'll have three more questions.
Yes, and it was friends of my eldest brother and one of my aunt Jo, who was took over for his brother. And my brother's day.
Did your feelings change when you arrived at your new home?
Not at first. The next day, when she offers, there was something, and funny enough, my eldest brother pointed it out. And she said and then each she never gave us a chocolate or the sweets out of the box.
And the houses, so your house that you were at in Manchester, instead, what were they completely different? Children?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. We had a good job.
No hot water, so you have to boil water.
That's fine.
You couldn't get hot water from a tap.
We just take all this for granted, don't we?
Yeah.
No. washing machine.
What was it, did they?
No, they was quite well off.
Yeah.
I was used to. Not really. While I was gone, yes. Yes. So we came back, they were right into my head to say what cruelty, what was going on. So when we got back home, and the cops, and we used to be going to school and picking sweets up off the floor because of the shops, all the sweets were on the floor.
Making the most of it.
Yes!
Yeah, they are.
Students from different schools. We've got, did anything scary happen while you were evacuated? Safe for being evacuated, I suppose it was scarier.
It was.
In the fact that
you
were, if you didn't behave, you were given the bell there. It was mixed, wasn't it?
It was
really sort of, that was for the claustrophobia, it was for the air raid. We've answered quite a lot. There was one that I'll come to finish off with that I thought was quite good. Transport, you evacuated, so you were trained. Did you prefer life when you were evacuated or were... Thank you very much. I love this one from one word. Terrible.
It was a great experience.
Enjoyable, super. Right. Well, thank you very much. I think we need to say massive coming in today. So, what do we say, guys? Oh.